cooking up. Then my windows is tinted as gold. My backseat ain't empty, we just left the Fendi. We getting it all over the place. This is why I need the fam. This is why I need.
What's up, everybody? It's your girl Brittany, and I'm back with another video. If you're new here, welcome. If you're new here, welcome back. Either way, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, share, all that. Yeah. So, y'all, happy Valentine's Day. Well, by the time I put this up, it'll be Valentine's Day. But yeah, either way, happy Valentine's Day, guys. You know, I hope you guys is. Valentine's Day is filled with love and, you know, etc., all that good stuff. But yeah, happy Valentine's Day. I really came on here because I don't know about y'all, but I'm single for Valentine's Day.
Aww.
Don't really have any plans, but you wanna know what I did do? I treated myself, you know? I got some Skittles, and then I bought myself this purse that I think is so cute, and I just love it so much. So I decided to just treat myself for Valentine's Day this year, because if I'm gonna do it, not like anybody else was gonna do it. So yeah, and then on top of that, I love myself, and yeah, I really just thought that I was gonna be down for Valentine's Day just because of the fact that I was single and whatnot. But I was just like, man, up there, why should I be mad when I can really just make myself feel good? So yeah, I got me some Skittles. And like I said, I bought this purse like, and it came like a few weeks ago, but this was really my Valentine's Day gift. It just came early. You know, bought myself a purse, you know, went to plug or whatever. So yeah, it's all good in the hood. And because of this, and because of it's Valentine's Day and whatnot, I just decided to give y'all a little story time about something that happened to me on Valentine's Day. And when I tell y'all this story, y'all gonna judge me. Honestly, I really don't care what y'all do, but y'all might judge me for sure. But yeah, y'all, you know, I'm gonna just tell the story. So y'all, one of the worst Valentine's Days I ever had that I can think of on top of my head was when I was with someone, like in a relationship with somebody. And looking back at it, like even replaying my previous relationships in my head, like I really just laugh on how unhinged everything was. And then now that the fact that I'm over it and made everything and I don't feel any type of emotion about it, then I don't care. But yeah, like this story, it's just funny, but it's just like, it's just so unhinged to me. It's just like, I don't even understand, or I honestly am surprised that that lasted for as long as it did, because even me sitting here looking back at old things, it's just like, bruh, like, do y'all ever get that feeling? So yeah, boom, yeah, one of the worst Valentine's Days I ever had, I was in a relationship with someone. I don't know if I told y'all before, I think I said, like, I'm 25 now, but when I was in college, like, years and years ago, I was with somebody for 75% of my college, the duration of the time I was in college, yeah. And if, man, yeah, I ain't even gonna get into all that. But yeah, so this specific day was Valentine's Day. I can't remember if this was like my junior or sophomore year or whatever, but it's just still a memory that was bought into my head just due to the fact that it was Valentine's, due to the fact that now it's Valentine's Day. But yeah, so in college, I was with somebody, and me and that specific person, of course, we were going to spend Valentine's Day together, of course. But February the 13th, mind you, oh, let me just say this. So, you know, I didn't have a car, so, you know, I got my gifts, my friends took me, and blah, blah, blah. So, you know, I was good. But that night, which is the 13th, I'm supposed to be going out with my friends, because, like I said, you know, we in college, you know, we were just having fun for no reason. Somebody said they was doing something for Valentine's Day, throwing a kickback. It was like, bet, we there. And then at the same time, yeah, I'm with somebody, but I'm still a young, cute college student. I want to go out and have fun. Like, the problem, one of the problems within that whole relationship was that, no lie, I was just young and turned. And like I said, I was in college, but I felt like I was never doing nothing disrespectful. I still was loyal. I still didn't give numbers out. I didn't dance on nobody. I was just out having fun. And that was really the main problem within my previous relationship. So, like I said, it was the day before Valentine's Day, actually. I went and I get my gift, and I'm just like, okay, cool. I'm going out with my friends, blah, blah, blah. And it was, and every time I said I wanted to go out, it was always an argument. And everybody knew it too. Like, I knew it, my friends knew it. They knew every time I said I wanted to go out, that old dude was gonna have an issue with me. You know, unhinged. So yeah, either way, it was just like, yeah, I'm going out with my friends, I'm gonna see you later. Mind you, it's not even Valentine's Day, it's the 13th. So I go out with my friends, and dude was just mad. And the reason why he was mad is because of the fact that I wasn't there at midnight, like as soon as Valentine's Day hit.
What?
And that was the problem. This is where the tension had started. I'm out with my friends, it hits midnight or whatever. Like, yeah, it's Valentine's Day, but dude, it's night. I still can wake up, go see the day, and we can still spend Valentine's Day together. Why are you mad that I'm not here on midnight? And I told you I was going out. Like, what? So me, like, we're probably going back and forth through text, but it's just like, F it. Like, I'm out. And every time I was out and we got into it, I never let that ruin my night, because it's just like, bro, you're not about to piss me off, you not about to stress me out. And he was really mad that he couldn't get under my skin and I wasn't getting mad and didn't used to react to him. So after that, you know, party dies down, you know, we're about to go. And so I did text him, and I think I asked, like, you know, hey, are you up, you know, because, you know, if you still want me to come through, then you know I'll come through. And so by this point, of course, yes, he's up, and we're going back and forth. But this time, I was getting pissed off. And it's just like, I was really getting pissed off. Like, I'm a very, very calm person. But once somebody take it there, then they take it there. And I do remember myself getting pissed off. And so I have my gift, and okay, yeah, so like I said, party dies down, arguing through text, blah, blah, blah. I get my gift, my friends drop me off, the door opens, and I'm mad. He's acting like everything's okay, but it's like, you going back and forth with me through text, you're pissing me off, you open the door, and now, like, I'm mad. Like, why are you not mad? You pissing me off, like, and he thought shit was sweet. Like, he was just pretending like nothing happened. And then even that whole time, that was pissing me off. So when I get into his room, I drop his present on the floor because I was mad. Like, yeah, so when I walk in his room, I drop his present on the floor in front of his face and don't say shit.
Huh?
And then it's just like, what? Like, what the fuck are you doing? Blah, blah, blah. And you know, of course, we just going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. It's getting heated. We going back and forth, back and forth. And like, and the crazy thing about this is that I was so mad and had such adrenaline rush that after the whole dropping the present on the floor thing, I do not remember any words that were being exchanged, what was going on. I just know that I am mad because it's like I said, you take it there. And it's like, and the only thing I hated when I used to get into it with him, and I was always at his house, is the fact that he had roommates and nobody just cared. It was just like, bruh, we sit here yelling, arguing, and just post it like that and nobody's just like, hey, like, is everything good? Like, everybody just let that shit be. Everybody minded their business. And it's just like, y'all don't hear this. Like, I could be getting hurt or something in here. Like, why nobody interfering? But yeah. And then after that, we stayed over argue all night. Even though it's Valentine's Day, it's like through the midnight to our 1, 2, 3 area. So it's like it's Valentine's Day, but it's just like, bruh, it's late at night, like, you know. But so go to sleep, we wake up, we ain't say nothing to each other that whole day. There was no Valentine's Day. The gift was still on the ground. At this point my gifts are on the ground just scattered. And it was just like, and I just remember just being like, damn, like, this is crazy. Like, by the time I woke up, I'm not gonna lie, I was probably over it, because it was just like, you know what, I don't even care anymore. But then at the same time, I really don't care to being intention, it bothers me. But then at that moment, it was like, it really didn't bother me, because I'm just still kind of irritated at this point, because it's just like, bruh, this whole reason you're mad at me because you wanted me to be here at midnight so we can officially spend Valentine's Day together, like, unhinged. Like, he was just so unhinged. Mind you, was I wrong for doing the whole, you know, being okay, was I wrong for the whole me dropping the present on the floor in front of the face thing? Yeah, I shouldn't have spiked it up like that. But it's like, at that moment, it was like, you really pissed me off. You want to argue with me all night. And then you want to get here and you want everything to be sweet. Like, you thought, since you thought you were over it, that we could just sweep it over the rug. But it's like, no, you were really picking fights with me all night and you expect shit to be cool. You got the reaction you wanted. You pissed me off. And now I'm pissed off. So this is what you wanted. Okay, like, what now? But yeah, we ain't talked that whole Valentine's Day. And I'm pretty sure we were just sitting down, chilling. We just set intention on separate sides, like, just not around each other. And honestly, at that moment, I really didn't care about the fact that it was Valentine's Day or whatnot. It was just like, dang, this had to happen on Valentine's Day. But it was just, at this point, I was really just irritated at the fact that I don't care what day it is. Like, you really just pissed me off and you were mad at something like this. Like, I just thought it was stupid. Like, and yeah, that's that was really one of the craziest and probably the worst Valentine's Day I've ever experienced. Yeah. Like, it is, like, looking back at it, I could really sit here and laugh at it, because like I said, honestly, we were just young and dumb. Like, we were just young. We were kids. We didn't need to be together. We had feelings, loved each other and whatnot. And we really thought that's what was going to make our relationship work. But nah, our relationship, looking back at it, it was low-key kind of unhinged. And like, it's like, I just really like, in a story like that, I mean, that's just like one of many. It was just like that whole time, like, it was just crazy. Like, the fact that we really stayed together for as long as we did is actually pretty freaking crazy. And it's like, yeah, that was probably the craziest Valentine's Day that I've experienced so far in my life. And hopefully that stays the weirdest experience. I don't want to have bad Valentine's Day, so hopefully that was just a unhinged, crazy type moment that just stays in the past, and it's just not something that gets weirder and weirder. Like, yeah, like, hopefully, yeah. But yeah, y'all, that's honestly all I came on here to say. Like I said, it just fit the Valentine's Day spirit. And like, not like I had anything interesting to do or say about my life currently. Like, I might as well talk crap about what happened in the past, you know. But yeah, I hope y'all have a good Valentine's Day. You know, I hope that it's filled with love. I hope even if someone is down in the dumps about whatever they're going through, as far as, you know, if it's single on Valentine's Day or just going through anything, period. Like, I hope something crazy as this puts a smile on your face. But, you know, yeah, I hope y'all have a good Valentine's Day. You know, if you are single, make sure you love on yourself. Don't depend on anyone else to do it for you.
Don't play with it, don't be dishonest. Ay, still not under-